Oh hey, I didn't see you there. How are you doing, kitty horse? I see you clicked on my video. If you clicked on this video thinking I'm pulling an all-nighter, you thought right, bitch. You might be asking why. Why are you pulling an all-nighter? Because sleep is for pussies. Is pulling an all-nighter healthy? No lol, but do we care? No. First step to pulling an all-nighter: get your ass in the shower and turn that bitch on cold. You will need this desperately to stay awake, since the last night you already stayed up till 4 AM watching Tana Mongo and Jeffree Star. Make sure to accidentally get shampoo in your eye because you're a dumb bitch. Wash that disgusting area of skin you call your face, you ball of grease. After you get out of the shower, dry your hair so you don't look like a wet rat. Make sure to clean your ears using a Q-tip, even though doctors tell you not to because it could lead to further issues, and you do it anyway. Brush your teeth because you don't know what type of filth is hidden in that hole in your face. Grab the closest hat because it would be an emotionally draining chore to put in the extra effort to blow dry your hair. After that is done, make sure to wear comfortable clothes because you will probably be wearing these for the next 15 hours. Anything like jeans are a hell no. Tonight is the night you bust out your favorite pajamas to give you good luck on the ruthless night you're about to embark on. If you have any melatonin, throw that shit away. Tonight we will put on big boy pants and take Adderall. That was a joke. Do not do drugs, kids. Other than behind-the-counter stimulants, you will need some boost to get you through the night. Even though these are equivalent to battery acid for your stomach. Always keep an average supply of snacks to fuel your brain. Remember, your body is a temple and you will forever feed it absolute garbage. Make sure to adjust your heat to a good ass level because you don't want to nip all night, and you also don't want to die of heat stroke, or maybe you do, depends on your preference. Do not turn off your lights because you in fact want the light to strain your eyes as much as possible. We have taken all of the needed precautions for a proper all-nighter, so saddle up, get comfortable, and grab your stimulant. It's going to be a long night. You are going strong, feeling productive, and optimistic about your life, which is rare because normally procrastination is your kink. Assignments are being started and are going well. Not really, you're just extremely in denial about your life choices, but we don't have to talk about that. You are making major progress on your classwork. Your eyes are starting to feel slightly heavy. Hell no, sleep is for the weak. You crack open your can of gasoline. If you focus hard enough, you can feel it slowly burning holes in your stomach. You're feeling slightly more awake than you were a few hours ago. Even though your eyes are starting to twitch and your whole body is shaking slightly, you're doing pretty good. You all of a sudden have AirPods in and are listening to Billie Eilish. Now in your feels and depressed about life. Now we're starting to venture into unknown territory. You haven't stayed up this late since middle school, when you were playing Minecraft while chugging Monster and eating cheese puffs even after your mom told you to go to bed. You're also contemplating if it would be a bad decision to acquire a sugar daddy. Most of your assignments are basically done, even though they are all mediocre and close to no effort was put into them. Your body is slowly starting to shut down on you. Most of your organs are screaming in multiple different languages, and you're pretty sure you're slowly going cross-eyed. You actually start to hallucinate and wonder if the gnome in the corner of the room is real. You fell asleep while sitting up because you actually went into an anxiety-filled, energy drink-induced, Billie Eilish, and gnome-infested coma. You couldn't handle the pressure. You pussy.